Recently, I put out three videos on my Instagram, and it was me editing videos like that I've never tried to edit before. So just a different category of videos. And those videos were dance videos. I've wanted to just kind of go for it and see what happens. Now, my first one, I did do the like trendy, super trendy glow line, whatever you want to call it, made very popular by Blotter Media. And it was fun. It was a lot of work. I didn't have a pen or an iPad or anything like that. I used a mouse pad to draw the lines frame by frame in After Effects. I wake up, flex, I'm down that check. No drip this. Wait. Tell them run it up. No sleep, no rest. Might crash, might wreck. But first I stretch. Tell them run it up. There's so many different ways to do it, and there's so many different tutorials, so you can go watch any of those. But after I did the first one, I was just like, yeah. I kind of didn't want to do it mainly because it took a lot of time and because I just wanted to do something a little different. And so I just wanted to play with like the transform effect. And let me just put this out there. I'm not the first person to do this. Many people have done this already, but I just think that it's a good way to just edit the videos in a simpler fashion. So out of the three videos that I posted on my personal Instagram account, the second one that I posted was the one that had the most amount of attention or most engagement just within my following. I don't have a huge following on Instagram, but from what I saw, all of my friends and people that I don't even know, they seem to love that one a lot. So what I want to do is I want to let you watch the video first. It's only like 20 seconds. And then I want to go through and talk about each effect that I use. I use Premiere Pro for every single thing. So you don't really need anything too fancy. It's a lot of keyframing and just trying to think outside of the box. And I'm not saying this is the way to do it, but I think it's a cool way to just add an extra flair to dance style videos in particular. See the drippy, I'm fitted up. Hop in my car and the giddy up. Secure the bag, yeah, I get the bus. Pick it up. You see the drippy, I'm fitted up. Hop in my car and the giddy up. Secure the bag, yeah, I get the bus. Pick it up. Ooh, I've been on a flex on. I was trying to figure out the best way to do this, so I think what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna put the effect on the screen. I'm not necessarily going to show you on Premiere. I might show some of them, but not all of them. So if we look through the first video or the first couple seconds. You know, they're bouncing back and forth, and right off the bat, I'm using just the black and white filter. Nothing too crazy. You literally just go to effects, black and white, and then you just throw it on there. While it's in the black and white, as you can see, the next thing, there's a quick zoom in when they do the pick it up part, and that's using the transform effect. And all I did was I keyframed the scale position. Once you know you use these keyframes with scale or position or anything like that, you can go down to the box that says use composition shutter angle, uncheck that box, and then I personally had the shutter angle at 200. And what that does is it adds the blur, like a motion blur pretty much. And so instead of just looking very stagnant, you kind of just zoom into a clip. It adds the blur as if I were, like if I did that in camera. So right after it zooms in and zooms back out, I kind of track her hand going up like that and then coming straight back down. All that is again, in the transform effect, I'm keyframing the scale and the position, and I'm trying to keep her hands in the middle of the frame. So that way it literally looks like it's like taking, you know, it's taking the viewer with the hands, and it's very quick. Some people don't even notice that's what they're following, but it's just because of that movement, it keeps you engaged. So right when the beat drops, the color comes back in. So I end the black and white filter, actually cut the clip into a separate part so that I could change it to the full color. And that quick like blurriness is a fast blur effect, and it's super, super quick. And it's like, let's see here, three frames to blurriness, and then blurriness to not blurriness, three more frames. That's all it is. And because it's so quick, because it goes with the music and the beat drops and everything, that's what like, I personally, that's my favorite part of the whole thing. I just love when music and audio visual just synchronization, whatever. As we're still watching, those quick little movements, That's again, transform effect. I'm scaled in though, and so that gives me the ability to move left and right with the position. Now, if you notice with the beat of the song, there's like a little, almost like a little scale kind of thing. What that is I use the offset effect, and all that does is it creates a separate, like a duplicate of your video pretty much, depending on how much you have it blended with the original, but it creates an offset. So it's like, right now what you're seeing is an offset version of myself, and you can position it where you want the offset to be, how much you want it to show, all that kind of stuff. And so I have it appearing very quickly and disappearing just with the beat of the song. So that gives it a little, well, just shook my camera. That gives it a little, yeah, that. So when they're doing this number right here and they clap, once again, transform effect, and all I'm keyframing there is the scale and the rotation. The way it looks so smooth is whenever you're editing things in Premiere, editing keyframes, you go to the keyframe, you right click, and you go to Bezier, and then you can actually drop down the arrow and edit the graph, and that makes a gradual smoothness to the thing, to the keyframe. So like for that part, I have it gradually going in and then gradually coming right back out. As we continue to go through the offset with the beat, okay, right there is, you know, when they tap their foot twice, that's the RG split. That's also a very popular effect that a lot of people use just in different things. A lot of people use it differently. I personally, the way I do it, I have the RGB color corrector. You can honestly just use like color balance and do red, green, or blue. And what that I do, I copy the clip three times, so I have three separate ones, and then I delete the original clip on the bottom, so you have three different layers of the same clip. The bottom clip, you choose it one color, middle one, top one, all that. The bottom clip, you want it to scale up, so you have the keyframe, it's at, let's say, 100 scale, it goes up to 105, and it comes back down to 100. The bottom clip, you want it to go up the biggest because it's under all those layers. And so like, let's say the bottom one goes up to 105 or 115, excuse me. The second one should go to 110 and the third one should go to 105. That way when it does happen, you can see all the colors at the same time. And what I did with this video is when they stomp their feet twice on the floor, I have it appear and disappear both of those times very quickly. And now as they're going along, the offset thing's still going on. And if you saw that little, I can't remember the lyrics, put the money in the bag, whatever, I don't know, get the bag, whatever. There's another zoom rotation kind of thing, and I just had that there to fill in because I just felt like it was kind of dead. And you might not like it, but I personally liked it, and just play around. That's what I encourage you to do. And as you go through the next part, pick it up. I added an adjustment layer and did a color filter. I used color balance, like I mentioned earlier, and I just changed the colors according to whatever color I wanted. With color balance, I tend not to use blue because sometimes it's just too dark. I personally love using colors, but I know that some people, you know, with epilepsy and stuff like that, I try not to use it too much. And then the very last part where they go like this, all that is the original clip, it scales up, and as it's scaling up, I keyframe the opacity, so it's at 100%, and then the opacity eventually goes down to zero. And under that is the original clip still, and I threw the black and white filter back on it. Now, what you might not have noticed watching the first time is the original clip, I'm just walking backwards away from them. But what I did was I scaled it in just a little bit as I was walking backwards, and that gives it a little dolly zoom or vertigo effect. And so I think that was like a nice little touch.
See the drip, yeah, I fit it up. Hop in my car and I get it up. Secure the bag, yeah, I get the bus. Pick it up. You see the drip, yeah, I fit it up. Hop in my car and I get it up. Secure the bag, yeah, I get the bus. Pick it up. Ooh, I've been on the flex since flex.
Slide with me if you feel like 550 on the 5 stick, you can get high with me, that's a deal, right? Ride with me if you ride with me, you can slide with me if you feel like 550 on the 5 stick, you can get high with me, that's a deal, right? That's a deal, right? That's a bet, right? That's a bet, right? That's a deal, right? That's a deal, right? That's a bet, right? That's a deal, right? That's a deal, right? That's a bet, right? That's a deal, right? That's a deal, right?
So So out of the three dance videos that I posted, this one was definitely my favorite one, like I mentioned earlier. And I think it's because my mind was so fresh with like, oh man, this would be cool, this would be cool. So that's how I edit those videos. I really do, that was weird. I really appreciate you watching this video. That's all I got for now. Bye.